Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I would like to thank the Club of Rome for giving Tata Steel, and I'm representing Tata Steel, giving us an opportunity to be expressing our views here. Price volatility is a bit of a, as Ma'am Henrietta also said, is a bit of a difficult subject. It's a subject that engages policymakers, economists, governments, ministries, and I'm not going to pretend to be able to explain it in the next 5 or 7 minutes. I'll only attempt to sensitize the audience, all of you, on what price volatility is and how it impacts sustainable development. If you look at the phrase, it purely is descriptive. In a descriptive sense, it refers to variations in economic variables over time. It's a function of price elasticity of demand. It's a function of price elasticity or inelasticity of supply. Does it have a significant impact on macroeconomic variables and sustainable development of economies? Economists are of the view that price volatility of key resources like oil, food, grain, and agricultural products, and even minerals have a significant impact on real GDP, exchange rates, unemployment, balance of payment, interest rates, and inflationary pressures on the economies. Especially for countries which are commodity dependent, price volatility is a big problem. And countries which are commodity dependent are typically either developing countries or the developed or underdeveloped countries. 95 of the 141 developing countries derive at least half of their foreign exchange earnings from commodity exports. And amongst all of this, around 2 billion people, nearly a third of the global population, is dependent on production of primary commodities like rice, cotton, cocoa, copper. But in the short term, commodity prices are highly volatile, sometimes varying about 50% in a period of 12 months. In fact, in the last 1 or 2 years, we have seen the specter of coal, which is a raw material to steel business, varying more than 100% in 6 months. So in the short term, these commodity prices are highly volatile and across a broad range of commodities. And in the past 30 years, there have been as many price shocks across the range of commodities as there were in the preceding 75 years. So the cyclicity has reduced, the frequency has increased. This inherent uncertainty of unstable prices, it complicates financial planning and environmental management for the countries which are commodity driven, which deepens further their dependence on commodities and widens the existing inequalities. And that is how it impacts sustainable development for them. On the other hand, consolidation amongst multinational commodity traders, consolidation as well as cooperation perhaps, this has led to a loss in market power by the majority commodity producing nations. So in the value chain of commodities, the power is transferring from the countries that are producing to the traders who are actually consolidating and cooperating for financial gain. The trends towards increasing volatile prices, slipping relative prices, and shifting power along the supply chain have left commodity-dependent countries and producers in a precarious position, grappling with the dual problems of low returns and very high risks. The same, of course, cannot be said of the traders or the corporates who have consolidated and gained this market power. The steel sector, to which I belong, has been at the receiving end of some of these dynamics. We consume iron ore and coking coal, which are commodities and basic resources, as raw materials for the steel business. A measure of the consolidation in the supplier or the corporates who are consolidating and perhaps cooperating can be understood by the fact that 63% of the iron ore that is traded around the globe is controlled by three companies. Similarly, around 56% of the hard coking coal that is traded across the globe is controlled by three companies. Volatility in prices of these materials, iron ore and coal, can be gauged by the fact that the annual contracting by their customers, annual contracting used to be a measure of stability in prices across the value chain. So if the prices of iron ore and coal were stable, those of steel would be stable, those of automobiles and construction equipment and everything, engineering products, would all be stable going forward and would contain the inflationary pressures on economies. But in the last 10 years, the volatility in these prices has resulted that the annual contracting by their customers has come down from 70% to 40% in a decade. And prices are managed more based on spot or based on index base, which is there to reduce the long-term risks, but this increases the volatility in the prices. Whilst this cannot be taken as the only reason for the precarious financial position of the steel sector globally, or the high incidence of NPA in India, it does point to the fact that steel is not as consolidated a sector as the supplier side, the raw material side, or the next link in our value chain, which is, let us say, the automobile sector is. Steel is not consolidated at all that way. But coming back to the commodity side, at the heart of the commodity price problem is the imperfect nature of the commodity markets. The theoretical ideal of a supply meets demand market equilibrium is rarely, if ever, actually achieved because commodity supply and demand forces respond inflexibly to price fluctuations. A lot has been written about how price volatility can actually be mitigated. A lot has happened across the world. But economists across the board agree that there is no one silver bullet to deal with the subject, and different economies, different situations have to be dealt with differently. There is a plethora of solutions possible, which is for policymakers, economists, and the governments to discuss. I wouldn't venture into that, and would consider the sensitization on the subject of price volatility here. Thank you so much.